वन सेकेंड। ओके बेसिल, योर नेम प्रोनाउंसिएशन इज बेसिल और बासिल?
मैं बासिल।
ओके ओके। देन ऑल ऑफ यू टेक वन पेपर। Write the question. Write a program. Write a program. To create an empty series. An empty series. Write a program to create an empty series. And write the output also. Write the output also. First question, write a program to create an empty series. Write the output also. Write a program to create an empty series. Write the output also. It's a 2-mark question. Then the second question. Explain the differences between series data structure and data frame data structure. Series data structure and data frame data structure with example. I'll give 10 minutes. Write fast. Okay. Evelyn completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So just WhatsApp me. Not on my number. 9946. All of you, note down. 9946574645. 9946574645. Okay. Meenakshi, okay. Lakshmi Nandas. Who is this Lakshmi? Okay. You are in which division, Lakshmi? Amal Anjo Meghna, switch on the video. Okay, Meghna, Evelyn, okay. Amal, okay. Anjo, okay. Five, four, four, who is this? Anna Salim, okay. Elvina, okay. Five, four, four, who is this? Last number, 544. 71544. Raina, okay. Elvina, Hanna. Raina, okay. Vidur, okay. Whose number is 71544? Meenakshi, okay. Seven one five four four. Noble Anil. Seven one five four four. Grishma, okay. Who is Noble? Noble, switch on the video. Okay. Then, whose number is 71544? Anthony's number. Okay. Just type the name. Okay. Grishma. Okay. Ashish. Okay. All of you submitted? Sana, you submitted? Sana? Okay, Anthony. Okay, Sana. Okay. The difference is one of the most important board exam question. Okay, difference between two data structures, that is the series data structure and data frame data structure. Amal, what is the difference between series data structure and the data frame data structure? What are the main differences?
Ma'am, the series one one definition data structure.
One is, it is correct. One dimensional. D4 dimensional. One dimensional.
One dimensional array. while data frame is a two dimensional array.
Then second point, Anjo.
We cannot change the size
in the case of
series data structure,
but in the case of data frame data structure, we can change the size. We do. What about the next point?
In series data structure, values are homogeneous, that is of same data type, and in data frame data structure, the values are of heterogeneous, that is different data types.
Okay. In series data structure, we can store only same data type values. That means if you are storing numbers, we can only store numbers. In the case of data frame data structure, we can store numbers, characters, strings all together. It is heterogeneous. Series data structure, it is homogeneous. Homogeneous means same data type can be stored. Then, any other difference, Grishma? One more is there. Size mutable already said.
Value mutable.
Size is we cannot change the size in series data structure. Okay, in data frame data structure only we can change the size. What about value, Hanna? In series and data frame. In series data structure, value
mutable.
But in the case of data frame data structure, values immutable. Okay, Hanna. Raina, what is the meaning of mutable and immutable?
We cannot change. Immutable means we can't
change. Mutable means we can change the values. That is mutable. Mutable means can change. We can edit the values. Then immutable means we cannot change the value. Is it clear? Then what about the second question, Evelyn? Our first question, that is write a program to create one empty series. What is the first statement?
Import pandas as PD.
Import pandas as PD. Then second statement?
S is equal to PD dot series bracket.
Okay. Then what about the last statement, Anthony?
Print this.
What is the output, Anthony? Output?
Output. A series bracket.
Series, D type, float 64. Okay, correct. Then we'll just discuss about the series data structure. So we discuss about how to create a list using empty series. So our program is write a program to create empty series. For every series creation program, the first statement is import pandas as PD. Vidhu, what is the meaning of this statement? Import pandas as PD.
We have to PD as pandas.
We have to import the pandas module from the Python's library, and we are giving a duplicate name for pandas. It is PD. Okay. We have to import pandas module from the Python's library. So many modules are there in Python's library. So if we want to use this pandas data structure in a program, first we have to import this pandas from the Python's library. For that, we will write import pandas. Then as PD means we just give one duplicate name for this pandas as PD. For For writing, every time for writing pandas, we write PD. For that purpose, we are giving a small name for pandas. It is PD. Grishma, you got the meaning? Okay, so the first statement, for every panda series data structure, for every panda series data structure, the first statement is import pandas as PD. Got it, Hannah? Is it okay, Hannah? Okay, so the second statement is S1 or S, any name you can give here. S1 is equal to, Raina? S1 is equal to?
PD dot.
PD dot. Series, S is capital letter, okay. Series, empty bracket. Then, next statement it is, print S1. Anthony, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then what about the result or output? In the output section, we have two arrays or two column values. Which are the two column values, Meghna?
Data type.
Data type is the data type. Okay, data type. What is the output? It is series within bracket. First is value. We have two things in output section. The first is the value and second is the data type. For data type, we write D type. For data type, we write D type. The default data type is float 64. Okay, so in the output section, here we are creating empty series. Empty series means no values are used in empty series. So we just write like this, empty square bracket, no values. This is empty series. But we have to write the data type. Here no value, so there is no data type for value, but a default data type is there. That default data type is float 64. So if there is no value, a data type is there, it is the default data type, that data type name is float 64. Is it clear, Amal? Okay, so for creating empty series, first we have to write the statement, import pandas as PD. After that, we have to create the series. For creating a series, first we have to write one identifier name. Here we can give any name. We can give S or S1 or SER, SER1, any name we can give here. Okay. After that, S1 is equal to, we have to use this pandas PD. PD dot series, it is empty list. So we here we are writing empty brackets. S is capital, series, empty bracket. So one empty series is created and that empty series is assigned to S1. Then print S1. Print S1 means the content of S1 is displayed. In this case, there is nothing in S1. So it will display like series, empty bracket, and also the data type. Here the default data type is displayed. The default data type it is float 64. Is it clear? Any doubt, Ashish? Ashish? Any doubt? Sana, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then I will explain the data types of this series data structure. Okay. This is the data type. In series data type, You just write after I will explain. Write the heading data type and series data type. Completed, Ashish? Ancho, completed?
No.
Okay. So, here we are using normal data type. In Python programming language, we are using some data types. What do you mean by data type? The type of data we are using in Python. That is float. Float data type means what? For what data we are using float data type? Meenakshi?
For
decimal values means if there is a number like 6.2, if you want to store a number 6.2, that is a number with fractional part. A number with fractional part is used in our Python program. The type of that data is float. Okay. For representing a number with fractional part, we are using the data type float. Is it clear, Raina? Then, what about integer? 186. This is a number without fractional part. So a whole number or a number without fractional part is represented using the data type integer or int. Okay, then what about date time? Date time is represented for, it is used for representing date. That is 12/6/2021. For representing our date of birth or representing our joining date. For that purposes, we are using a date value. For that value, we are using the data type date time. So the data type of a date is date time. And what about bool? Bool is for boolean values. Boolean value means either 0 or 1. For representing true or false value, we are using bool data type. The next is string, or it's a mix of string and integer. Either we can use string or integer. Okay. So the first data type used in Python is float. Float means a number with fractional part. Okay. Then next is integer number. Integer number means a number without a fractional part. That is, a whole number is known as integer. Or the data type is int. Date time means to represent a date, we are using the data type date time. Then bool is for representing true or false value. Then string and integer mix. So in series data type, if the content is a float value, the representation of series data type is float 64. 64 is the bit number, 64 bit. Okay. So in the output section, in series data structure, if the data value type is float, it will display like float 64. If the series data structure include integer numbers, then the data type is int 64. If your series data type include date time, a date, joining date or admission date, then it is represented as date time 64. Then if it is a Boolean value, it will just display bool. Same in the case of data type and series data type. In our output section, we need this series data type. Okay. Data type, series data type is needed for our output representation. That's why I'm explaining these. That is for float, the series data type it is. In the above program, what is the output? It is series, square bracket, then write D type is float 64. So we have to write the type also. If the content of a series data type data structure is float value, then the D type is float 64. If the content is integer value, then the data type is int 64. If the content is date, then the data type is date time 64. Then if it is a Boolean value, there is no 64, just write bool. Then if it is a mix of characters, strings or integers, then we write object. That means if a series include values like A, B, C, then what is the data type of this series data structure? It is object. Okay. If you are using characters in a series data type, the data type is object. If you are using string in series data structure, then the object data type is object. Is it clear, Hannah? Okay. Elvina?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So if the entered series value is a character, set of characters, then the data type we write the data type as object. And if it is a string, it is represented as object. Data type value is object. If it is 6.1 comma 5.2 comma 6.0. Ashish, what is the data type of this data series data structure? Ashish? Ashish? Ashish, okay, then Sana?
Yes, ma'am.
Which is the data type used here in this series data structure? What is the data type of this series data structure? Sana? Sana, in series data structure, we are using fractional numbers or a number with fractional part. So this is a floating point number. So the data type of that number is, which one, Evelyn?
Float.
Data type of that number, it is?
Float
64. Okay, float 64. Then, Sana, what about this one? Sana, switch on the video. Ashish is also not there. Anthony? What is the series data type of this series?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the data type? Series data type. Anthony? What is the data type of this series? We are storing integer values here. Isn't it, Anthony?
Yes, ma'am.
So, what is the data type? We are storing integer values. For integer value, what is the data type used? It is int 64. Is it clear, Anthony?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Amal, what about this data type? For this series data structure, which data type is used?
Float.
Float 64, correct answer. So if you are storing fractional number with fractional part, that is, if you are storing a decimal number, then it is represented as float 64. And if it is one, integers are stored in series data type, the data type is int 64. Integer means a number without a fractional part. Then if you are storing date, the data type is date time 64. If you are storing string, the data type it is object. Okay.